Sir Simon Fraser says the UK side has been a bit absent from discussions and there are too many differences in the Cabinet on the issue.
Now, Conservative Eurosceptics have insisted the UK should not pay the rumoured divorce bill of £36 billion, while Downing Street has dismissed the reported figure. Joining us now to talk about this is the Daily Mail's Andrew Pearce and former Labour adviser, I'm going to get this wrong, Aisha Hazarika.
Well done.
Did I get that right?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, well, a former Labour adviser and stand-up comedian.
Yes, on my way to the Edinburgh Festival.
Well, just hang that out. That's a great thing, the Edinburgh Festival. Andrew, let's start with you. There are so many different sides to this argument. £36 billion. Yeah. The people that voted out will go, why do we have to pay anything if we just want to leave? Mm. The Remainers will say, well, we agreed to all sorts of things and you can't just divorce without having to pay for that. Views?
Well, we're not married to the EU, actually, so we don't have to pay a divorce bill. We're in a club, so if I leave my club at my gym, I give them notice. Mm-hmm. We've given the EU notice. It's called 2 years yep. from when we signed Article 50. And at the end of that period, March 2019, we can leave. We have to pay all our bills up until then. We pay 10.8 billion euros every year, so that's 22 billion euros or so we owe them. Plus, there'll be a few other issues. But there is nothing whatsoever in the treaty, which we signed when we joined the European Union, to say there has to be a one-off payment when you leave. And you know why? Because nobody ever thought anybody would have the courage or temerity to say, up yours,
I don't think anybody ever thought that anybody would leave, did they?
They did not. I mean, Aisha says the stupidity. Aisha thinks 17.4 million people are stupid. I don't. I think they were exercising their democratic right to say we don't want to stay in the EU.
We said this morning, whether you were for or against it, democracy in a referendum, the British people spoke. Surely that's the point, isn't it?
Yeah, but Aisha thinks we're stupid, she says.
I think that democracy did win, and I think we have to respect the decision, but nobody wants a broke Brexit. Nobody voted to be poorer. Nobody. I've spoken to people who voted leave. They don't regret their decision.
Don't.
But they're small business people. They're very worried about what's going to happen to the economy. And look, we've hit this point where austerity is a big issue. We don't have enough money to fund the health service. His lot said that we'd be getting money back from the EU to fund the health service on that big bus.
That's true.
That's not happening. Turns out we probably won't be leaving for quite a long time because it's very complicated.
Can I ask you a very quick question, though, seriously? Because there are two sides as ever, you know, his lot, your lot. Do you think that the British people knew enough about the ramifications of voting out last June, this alleged divorce bill, all of this free trade movement, how people are going to move if they want to go to other countries? Do you think that it became just a yes or a no? And there wasn't enough information. Too many party leaders and politicians jumped on whatever bandwagon and didn't say, do you know what? There will be a divorce bill. You won't be able to perhaps go to Spain without filling in this thing we're going to talk about later, the SDR, all that sort of stuff. Maybe enough wasn't told to the British people.
I completely agree with that. I completely respect the mandate and everything like that, but it was... No, I'm not asking for a second referendum or anything. What you guys can't accept, that this is like a leap in the dark with a blindfold on. We have no idea how this is going to pan out. And not enough information was given to people. And now, as I said, I'm not saying change the decision, but even people who voted leave are seriously worried about the jobs and the economy.
OK. You said, didn't you, Andrew, that if you leave the gym, you give notice and you go.
Yeah.
But if you still want to use some of the equipment, you've got to get a deal. And that's the point, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, what we're saying here is we want to go, but we'd still like to do this and we still want to trade. It's not like we're walking away and never touching Europe again. Well, so that's what this figure is related to. And the question is, how much do we pay for it?
Well, the figures, where these figures come from, I mean, I think they're being plucked out of thin air because I don't think there's a minister's agree to this figure of 36 billion. Some officials are saying it. To use the analogy of the gym, there will be a transitional deal. There's no doubt we leave in March 2019, but it'll be up to 2 years. The argument in the Cabinet, there's been one argument, is it 2 or is it 3 years?
I think most people say 2. Well, when Boris Johnson says they can whistle and the other people say we'll pay £36 billion,
of course,
isn't it? It's like a business deal.
Exactly.
It's somewhere in the middle, won't it?
It's negotiations, it's men, of course, because where's the Prime Minister in all of this? She's away on holiday.
Walking.
God help us all, because we know what happened the last time she went on holiday. We had a general election. What's she going to do this time?
Said this morning Putin was caught with nothing on with a fish. One wonders what Theresa May will be doing.